Good morning friends. In the today's session, we are discuss the interrelated components of ATM switching. There are three planes of the switching function in the contents of the broadband integrated service digital network, which is called as BISDN model. And these three planes is nothing but user plane, control plane, and management plane. Let's see one by one discuss with them. What is meant by user plane? The main function of an ATM switch is to relay user data cell from input port to the appropriate output ports. User plane main function is nothing but the switch to relay whatever the data are available, and this available data set, the time specification can be maintained through an appropriate address into the input port to the output port. Whatever the data are available, which functions can be generated in the case, then will be sent from input port to output port and switch the network. The second activity performed through the user plane is nothing but the switch process only the cell headers, and the payload is carried transparently. Means the second process will be executed through the header cell. A header cell is nothing but the address specification, whatever the payload are available into the switching one place to another place. The transparently how awaited data can be a carry forward with the help of headers, they can switch the process. As soon as the cell comes in through the input port, the virtual path identifier, virtual channel identifier, VPI, VCI information is derived and used to route the cell to the appropriate output port. In this case, the n number of input ports are available. Through this port, the data easily sent into the virtual channel also. We know that the virtual or network channel, whatever the a basic computer system or computer network which are used to convert the data from one place to another place. Through that specification, they are easily move the data from virtual channels and go through that deliver path using the appropriate output ports also. So now the second one plane is nothing but the control plane, which are most important because of how to control in the signaling, how to control the switching concept into the ATM. This plane represent function related to the establishment and control of the virtual path, virtual channel connection. Whatever the main path is available, how to data transmit from one channel to another channel, the path will be a selection, and this selected path is an well established or not. When it is established well, then which functioning can be performed, which address specification is the important for the n number of packets, n number of routing specifications, etc. They check and apply the controls also, and this control is nothing but whatever the information regarding for the one communication channel to another communication channel, which is also called as a sender side and receiver side, to easily move the data from one place to another place. With the help of n number of controls, whatever the protocols we have to design, no one can access the data, no one can handle the data, which is totally transparent for the existing system through the network channel and pass to the receiver channels also, or receiver side also. This is the functions related controls can be managed through the control plane. Now the second activity they can perform, and like the user data cells, information in the control cell payload is not transparent to the network. The switch identify signaling cells and even generate some itself. Most of activity perform in the second one. The payload cannot transparent to the network. So how it will be possible that link should be execute and then switch identify the signaling cells. Whatever the signals can be generate, that signal should be appropriate for the transferring the data or not, and how to get the some data for its specification wise, and all those the controls are available, they should be generate itself with the help of a different design protocols. These protocols will be managed through the concept of switching mode of network, and this switching mode is nothing but the ATM switching channels. Through the control plane, they are easily execute the function, upload the load for the a further identification given pass by the identifiers, and through the channel activity the signal will be a pass from the receiver side. Then those unsatisfactory data or unusability data, the cannot apply into the transparent mode. These signals and this control also be activated through the control plane channel. Now the third one channel is nothing but the plane is nothing but the management plane. This plane represent functions related to the establishment and control of the virtual path, virtual channel connection. Establishment of the control plane will be provided through the management plane, and this management plane is perform the activity. The management plane is concerned with monitoring the controlling the network. Whatever the controlling or control plane should be activate over here, and through this activities to controlling the network to ensure it correct and efficient operation can be performed or not. So which type of efficient operation can be performed or not, this operation is defined in the different one operations also, or subdivided operations also, the given list for in the slide. The first operation can be provided through the management plane with the help of n number of controlling over here, the fault management function. Which type of fault are generate, how to manage that particular fault, which activities can be very much important for managing that type of fault. Whatever the hardware specification is there, software specification is there, addressing is there, and interrelated to network systems, hardware component and software component which are manage that particular fault. This activity can be performed through the fault management function, and this fault management function is a one of the control for the management plane. So now a second one operation can be delivered to the performance management function. So what type of performance can be provided by the system through? This performance also calculate. How to calculate it? To sending the data from the sender side. How to design a particular data, and that data should be a pass or not in the given system into the particular network. So which type of file execution is important for the higher speed of data transparency? Which type of file allocations is required for the supporting of hardware specification? This management performance will be calculated, and this calculation will be provided to the performance of management function. Also, the receiver side can take on that particular functions also, a performance management function. Whatever the response are given through the particular action provided by ATM, this performance also be a major into the like this similar one for the uploading concept and downloading concept, which are a simple language converted it's them. So system performance will be calculated, and this calculated system performance to manage how to increase the specification or how to maintain that particular specification, that will be maintained within that. So now next subdivided operation is nothing but the configuration management function. Configuration management function, whatever you have to send the data into the receiver side, that time we don't know which type of system, which configured type of system are available into the sender side, which type of specification or configuration can be maintained into the network system. We don't know whatever the action can be performed into a specified data, so that all these configuration can be easily maintained, managed, and then transfer the data from one place to another place. Like a system example for there, whatever the you call made through the a particular organization like Airtel, you have to call some others number, and others numbers have getting specified another one organization like a Vodafone or BSNL, Jio, etc. So that how to manage that particular two organization, this configuration will be a different one configuration available on the system or network. Then all these things continuously manage into the configuration management function. This one of the control pass by the management plane. We get out get the functions for the encrypted data goes through a network. Then the ATM switching concept manage all these things to manage the configuration. What configuration are required for the furthering data accessing? How many RAMs? How many hardware specification? Network speed specification, etc., etc. This configuration also be managed through the functionality, its functionality, and perform the action. This will be a one of the control over here to manage the management plane. A next one, a important function is nothing but the security management function. So that the security management function, it's an important one because of the a secured data is most important for the sending and receiving side. So which protocols we have to develop, which protocol we have to maintain that particular security reasons, that security functionalities, this is nothing but the security management system. How to identify the authentication, how to remove the unauthenticated person, these are the n number of things easily maintained through that security management functions. So now the next one important operation complete through the accounting management. Whatever the n number of functions, n number of signaling can be passed through that particular network in the virtual network also. So into the logging session to up to date or up to time, whatever n number of signaling can be passed into the appropriate network. So how to manage that, how to confirm that, and how to secure that, this total accounting or accountability can be managed over here. Like a performance for prepix, postfix actions are included in the protocols, and that protocol should be managed. Who are the first come and first serve? Who are the first one priority? That priority should be action done into the specification of protocols. They will be easily maintained. So accounting management is nothing but to manage the all those things which are most important regarding that to the queue process. Now in the traffic management system, whatever the network's functionality, we know that very well. The lot of traffics are available into the network. So a simple data can be transferred from one place to another place through the traffic management. My data cannot be lost. The signal processing cannot be lost into the sender to receiver in between them in network management. So the data transfer from one place, or one place is nothing but the sender side. Okay. The system will be a transfer the data from another one side or the receiver side. But the network traffic is a high position, high level of traffic are arising into the network. That time my data should be, a data is nothing but the n number of packets over here. My data should be appropriately goes to the receiver side. So how to manage that particular traffic? Which data can be important for the downloading? Which data is a valuable data for the system analysis? That should be provided into the switching section. So this operation can be easily maintained through the traffic management system. So the management plane will be a most appropriate subdivided operation can be performed into the different one section, and that should be a design, a specified protocol to perform the efficient operation with the help of monitoring that controlling the network. Okay, these are the major three different planes are discussed into this session: user plane, control plane, and management plane. Okay, thank you.